The aim of humanity to discover more about the cosmos inspired the space race, which was a competition between nations to be the first to explore space. If all these interest you then, you have come to the right channel. So today, we will be talking about what exactly China has discovered on the moon, only in the future space, so let's get started. On the moon, Chinese scientists have found a hitherto unknown mineral. Changesite Y is the sixth kind of mineral that human explorers have found on the moon. In light of the recent approval of the fourth phase of lunar missions, China is accelerating the pace of its lunar program. The cratered surface of the moon is the next major objective for nations from all over the world, as they compete not just to investigate it, but also to make progress into deeper space. At the time, China was one of the leading participants in the competition, and the recent finding is helping to improve its prospects. According to officials from the China National Space Administration and the China Atomic Energy Authority, during a news conference in Beijing, China has become the third country in the world, after the US and Russia, to have discovered and identified the first lunar mineral, Changesite Y, which belongs to the category of lunar merrillite. This was announced by the officials from the China National Space Administration and the China Atomic Energy Authority. The mineral, which has a single crystalline particle with a diameter of 10 microns, was painstakingly isolated by researchers from more than 140,000 minute particles, as stated by the Beijing Research Institute for Uranium Geology, which is one of the key institutions of China National Nuclear Corps. The lunar samples that were recovered by scientists weighed around 1,731 grams and were the first lunar samples to be recovered by scientists in more than 40 years. In July of 2021, the China National Space Administration dispersed the first batch of Change 5 lunar samples to research institutions across the world. The head scientist of the Institute's Lunar Sample Research indicated that the finding of the new mineral will assist researchers in their investigations into the history and physical characteristics of the moon. Chinese scientists have discovered a significant finding on the moon that might vault their nation into a select group of nations that includes only the US and Russia. This development comes at a time when the space race between China and the US is heating up. According to Xinhua News Agency, the CNSA and the CAEA jointly announced on September 9 that researchers investigating samples brought back from the moon by China's Chang'e 5 mission had found a new lunar mineral. This is the first time China has found a new mineral on the moon, and it is just the sixth one ever found by humans. China is now the third nation in the world to discover a brand new mineral on the moon, according to Dong Bao Tong, the deputy head of the CAEA. The recently found mineral known as Changesite Y is a columnar crystal that is transparent and colorless. After scrutinizing lunar basalt pieces obtained by the expedition, a research team from the Beijing Research Institute of Uranium Geology, which is a subsidiary of the China National Space Administration, made this discovery. After receiving the initial 50 milligrams of lunar samples in July 2021 to conduct a mineralogical inquiry, the research team found indications that the moon contained a previously unknown mineral. However, because the particles of lunar soil are so minute, scientists were unable to gather the information essential to correctly identify the mineral. Researchers from the Beijing Research Institute of Uranium Geology were finally successful in separating one crystal particle with a radius of approximately 10 microns from the 140,000 lunar sample particles to decipher the crystal structure of the crystal. These researchers used cutting-edge techniques such as X-ray diffraction. The head of the research team at BRIUG, Li Ziying, believes that the finding is extremely important for the study of lunar minerals, the evolution of the moon, and the development of deep space travel. The Chang'e 5 lunar expedition successfully arrived on the moon in December of 2020 after having traveled there for just less than 2 years. The International Mineralogical Association's Commission on New Minerals, Nomenclature, and Classification has formally recognized Changesite Y as having unique mineral characteristics. This acknowledgement was made by the Commission on New Minerals, Nomenclature, and Classification. This discovery comes only a few months after it was revealed that the Chang'e 5 mission safely returned with lunar rocks that can fill significant gaps in the history of the solar system. According to sources from Space News, the Chinese spacecraft Chang'e 5 returned from its trip to the moon in 2021 with 3.81 pounds of lunar rock. Two extremely small bits of the moon rocks were radiometrically dated and found to be roughly 1.97 billion years old. This makes them at least a billion years younger than the moon rocks that the Apollo expedition brought back to Earth. China and the US are engaged in a geopolitical competition in space, and China is fighting against the U.S. to threaten the U.S.'s hegemonic position. The discoveries and accomplishments made by China on the moon take place against this background. Analysts have gone as far as to predict that the success of China's uncrewed mission to the moon could be a precursor to more advanced missions, including manned ones and the construction of lunar bases. This prediction was made because analysts have gone so far as to predict that the mission was successful. As a result of the fact that experts have gone to the extent of predicting that the mission was successful, this forecast was made in light of that fact. In 2020, the Chang'e 5 lunar probe mission accomplished a successful landing on the moon, which was a significant win for China's space program. The objective of the mission was to go to the Mons Rumker region, located in the northern part of the moon, collect samples weighing a total of 2 kilograms, and then transport those materials back to Earth. China is just the third nation in the world to accomplish this goal since it was originally tried, following what is now known as the United States and what was then known as the Soviet Union. The USA collected 382 kilograms of lunar rock and soil during a total of 7 human Apollo spacecraft missions between 1969 and 1972. Of these 7 missions, 6 were successful. Between 1970 and 76, the nation that was formerly known as the Soviet Union deployed robotic probes to the moon, and those probes returned 301 grams of lunar soil. China made the statement at the beginning of this year that as part of the fourth phase of its lunar exploration program, a constellation of satellites would be built orbiting the moon as part of its lunar exploration program. This particular constellation's mission would be to facilitate future communication and navigation systems for use on the moon. As such, expeditions are now in the planning stages. China will play a leading role in the development of a portable communication and navigation system that is capable of employing the moon as a relay. There is a remote chance that the teeny tiny constellation won't be formally recognized until 2023 or 2024. In addition to this, it actively sought the collaboration of international partners in carrying out its objective. In addition to China's multi-pronged lunar probe that is being carried out throughout several separate missions, China is also working with Russia to establish a lunar base to compete with its competitors, who are led by the US. This is being done to ensure that China remains at the forefront of the space race. In line with the roadmap, which is broken up into 3 different phases, the station is expected to get an additional 5 amenities as well as 9 modules. These upgrades are meant to facilitate lengthy as well as short excursions to the surface of the moon as well as journeys into lunar orbit. It is projected that the construction of the station will be completed in 2035. The US, for its part, is all prepared to return with a human mission to the moon with its Artemis 1 launch rescheduled for later this month. The launch was originally slated for earlier this month. However, China's never-ending pursuit has put the U.S.'s well-established lunar program in jeopardy. Bill Nelson, the head of NASA, recently gave an interview to the German daily Bild, in which he speculated that China may one day arrive on the moon and claim the satellite as part of its territory. That's all for today. We will be right back with more such information. Until then, please do like the video and subscribe to the channel.